What have Doner Kebabs, raves, and Michelin stars got in common? Nothing, actually. Nothing at all. Until now. We're here at Freight Island to meet the Berlin-inspired Michelin-starred chef who's bringing his post-rave snacks to Manchester. What separates this from your average run-of-the-mill kebab?
This will taste just as good at 2 p.m. as it will at 2 a.m.
Straight in with the insults. It's one of the last things you'd expect from a Michelin star chef. What do you normally do? What's your proper job?
I own a restaurant called Carter's and Mosley in Birmingham.
Yep.
I've had it for 10 years. It's had Michelin star for 6. Everything's about like British sustainability, cooking from the island, the way it would have been years ago with a modern execution. This is well connected to that because it's the same products that I would use in my Michelin star restaurant.
Right.
The lamb's from Cornwall. Chicken is all from the Cotswolds, all British free range chickens.
Listen, I think we need to just get stuck in.
The chicken's made with the thighs. We layer it up shawarma style and then we marinate it in a couple of secret things. Butter, garlic, gochujang, loads of nice, amazing things to make it our own.
Shit, man. That's something else. That's absolutely unreal. The chicken's quality.
Roast garlic mayonnaise as well on the top.
Do you know what's good as well? The bread.
Obviously, it's a vehicle for everything, but
it's one. Hold it.
It's got to hold it. So there's a lot of juice, a lot of sauce, a lot of salad. So that's got to hold together. So every bite should just be holding all the flavour. It's made locally in a bakery that specialises in this, and it's Turkish peed.
So what's this called?
So this is techno slaw.
Techno slaw. Nice.
So it's got mushrooms in it, but they're safe.
Right.
The colour comes from turmeric.
That's unreal.
So we season it with soy sauce instead of salt as well, so it doesn't draw out as much liquid. Coleslaws
can... Nice, it stays moist.
All of them options are with potato smileys, because that's a nod to my sort of days in the rave scene.
You're a big old raver, aren't you, mate?
I still am.
At your age?
How dare you? Potato smileys is my favourite food of all time. I do them in my restaurant.
Michelin starred chef, your favourite foods are potato smileys?
Still are. Why would you eat a chip when you can eat a chip that looks like a face?
In a kebab shop, I'd always go doner over shawarma.
Me too.
Always.
So this, we make in exactly the same way, obviously all by hand. We're making a emulsified sausage out of the lamb shoulder. So that means we add frozen milk to it.
Frozen milk?
Incorporate that in by adding it in a blender or a mixer. And that would add all the air and make the meat really spongy. And the best word to describe it is boingy.
It is boingy?
Yeah. And it should be, so you get that tug of meat, just like a frankfurter.
Honestly, the flavours are unreal.
Yeah.
Like, no disrespect to the lads that are selling kebabs till 2 a.m. in your local town centre. But when you eat that, it's a bit like sucking on your granddad's slipper. Do you know what I mean? Like the aftertaste in your mouth. But with this, it's like I'm getting all the flavours just sitting on top of my tongue.
A kebab shop's always going to be looked at for the doner. So we really spent some time on getting the sausage like, just like it tastes in the chippy, but using the best quality meat, the best spice mix. And like, you try it and you're like, kebab can be this good.
Yeah.
So this is where I'm going to come and eat them.
Because for those people that would go, no, I don't want a posh kebab. I just want an old school kebab. It still tastes like an old school kebab.
It's got the satisfaction, right?
Exactly the same texture, same taste, but just more flavour. It's perfect for Freight Island as well, isn't it?
It's made to be here.
Yeah, because you've got that rave thing going on.
Yeah, it's really well connected to like here and the clients who come and the people have a good time. Because what I do is very niche and there's a small percent that are into it. But whereas this, you know, everyone's going to be into it.
Everyone likes a kebab, don't they?
Yeah. And hopefully when they all pile out the warehouse, they come to one star banner bar.
And sometimes I get in trouble for saying this is the nicest thing I've ever had in my life, right? But without exception, that's the best kebab I've ever had.
Do you hear that?
Can you hear that? The nicest kebab I've ever had. Fact.
I'll take that. Thanks, mate.
All right, man. Tell you what, he's knocking out some great gear in there. Oh, great gear.